Hi, it's Saturday today, so today's the time for some quick workspace hacks. So today's objective, the main objective for today, is actually this, the Drevo BladeMaster Pro. So this is the Drevo BladeMaster Pro. It's a full wireless mechanical RGB keyboard. It's using the Cherry MX Blue Keys, at least that's the one I got it with. It came out on Kickstarter in March or April 2018, and the moment I saw it, I kind of had to jump on it immediately because this is kind of my dream keyboard. It's 10 keyless, it's mechanical, it's wireless, it has the volume control, and I'd like to point out that for the wireless on this, it is not just Bluetooth. It uses a 2.4 GHz 1 millisecond wireless connection, so that's probably as good as like Logitech's Lightspeed or something similar. So the main problem with this keyboard though is that actually now you see it in its full wireless glory, but most of the time I actually have it connected with the USB-C cable for power. And this is because the RGB light makes it have really horrible battery life. Like we're talking maybe 1 to 2 days max. Sometimes better, sometimes worse. Actually, most of the time I use it in a different profile setting where the RGB lights are off, but that kind of defeats the purpose for even buying an RGB keyboard in the first place. So I've been wanting to kind of solve this long term, right? And you would have probably seen a lot of hack videos online about installing an invisible wireless T charger right into your desk. I'll link some below. But yeah, so people have done that obviously for handphones. And if you want to get wireless charging capabilities with your mouse, Logitech, Corsair, and some of the other players have also provided a mouse pad that can help you do something similar. But what I haven't seen was a wireless charging keyboard. So one day I just wondered, why can't we do that? So yeah, so I went on the Lazada and I kind of bought two things that I figured would solve that problem. Of course, first of all, is just a standard wireless T charger that you can get just about anywhere. But the second most important thing is this. This is the base US wireless T receiver. It's a USB-C wireless T receiver, and you can basically hook it up to any device, and the device would immediately have a wireless charging capabilities. So yeah, I'm going to try and hook this up to my keyboard and install the T charger into my desk, and let's see what happens. The first thing we're going to do is install this, the base US receiver, onto the keyboard, and then we're going to figure out the placement of the keyboard in relation to the monitor and on the desk, and then I'm going to mark out exactly where we're going to do the works on the table. So yeah, inside the package you get the receiver with the USB-C connector and a little bit of tape to kind of stick it to the keyboard. So yeah, let's try it out. And I think pretty straightforward, you just stick it in and you kind of just be able to stick it down here. It doesn't really have a clear direction of how it sticks. I'm just gonna try it out. So once it's on, of course, the ideal thing to do is to test it out with the T receiver first before we proceed further. But I'm pretty confident that this should work. So this is the T receiver. It's pretty thin, as you can see. So most people actually, when they drill their desk, they go from the bottom and then they leave that little tiny bit of the table surface, and then you kind of mount the receiver there. That's how they get the invisible effect on the table surface itself. But actually this table that I'm using right now, it's a pretty old table. It's been in the family for like a good, I think 25 years or so. And because of wear and tear over the years and all that, what we actually did was we stuck a vinyl wrapping over the tabletop because the surface itself was wearing out. So actually this makes it even easier for me to install a wireless T charger invisibly, because actually what I can do is drill from the top And then when I'm done, I'll just cover back with a new piece of vinyl wrap, which I still have. Yeah. So let's start by testing the receiver. I'll just plug it in here. Lights up nicely, although I probably won't be able to see that RGB effect. And I'm just going to check if it actually keeps the keyboard charging. And yeah, the charging light actually does come on, so you're definitely getting power to the keyboard. So now what I want to do is position the keyboard correctly to where my usual typing position or gaming position is. And then I'll mark it out. And then of course, I'll also mark out the position for the charger before we start drilling. So I usually don't have the keyboard too far away from the edge. And although at work, I kind of like it more towards the center, but for gaming, I actually like it a lot more to the left. And I kind of found like a ergonomic hybrid position where it's slightly off center. But actually, it doesn't really matter. It's a wireless keyboard, so I can move it anywhere I like. I just need to move it back to this position whenever I want it to continue charging. So yeah, first off, I will probably just mark the table to make sure that I know this is where my keyboard will be. And yeah, we'll probably start drilling after this. So, interestingly, this table is actually hollow. So actually, I didn't need to drill all the way through. And yeah, the inside part of it is hollow. So I'm just gonna like refine the edges a little bit more and I should be able to fit this thing in. And if it's not level, I actually have some wood putty to kind of level it up. And yeah, it's not easy to make a perfect shape, but I guess that's what the wood putty is for. Yeah, let's continue. So I now have two holes, one for my keyboard charger and one for my phone charger. This one doesn't fit perfectly yet, but it's gonna take some time to get it perfect. Let's do the wood putty and the finishing. Now I finally finished removing the vinyl wrap that took almost a full hour, and now I'm on my last stage. So basically I'm gonna try and like fill out the holes nicely, make it more level, and I'll be using this, which is wood putty and maybe some sandpaper, and see if I can kind of make it as flat as possible before I stick on a new piece of vinyl wrap. Okay, I think I'm done. I know this looks like a pretty shoddy job, but once I apply the vinyl wrap, it should look good as new. I just hope it can still charge perfectly under this layer of wood putty. Okay, let's get into it. Wow, that was one really long day. It took me way longer than I expected that to get all this done. But of course, that also includes some of the cleanup, the recabling, and some of the additional hacks that I was doing around my workspace. So I think you may have noticed some other differences on top of just these two chargers.
compared to what I was filming earlier today. But I think I will go into a proper workspace tour and share a little bit more of how I set up my PC, my Mac Mini, my MacBook Pro, my work laptop, and yeah, in general, how I set up my home workspace. For now, I have my wireless keyboard charging, and I have my phone charging as well on these invisible chargers. So I would consider this a very successful hack. Certain things weren't done very well, like the vinyl wrap this time around. I think I did better the first time, but this second time, I guess I got a little bit impatient. I didn't stick it on as well. But hey, this isn't a professional job, so it was a great attempt. And of course, I can always change it out to a different color. I can always change it to a different wrap anytime I wish. So no big deal there. Yeah, so stay tuned for more smart home budget hacks from future videos from this channel. Thank you for watching.